If we didn't have hope for getting that promotion, why would you work harder? If we didn't have hope for finding that perfect spouse, why would we try to court people that we're interested in? If we didn't have hope to live a comfortable, wonderful life, why do we work so hard in life? We do all these things because we have hope. Hopelessness is not a state that any of us want to be in. So in this video, I'm going to talk about how to recreate, regain, restore hope when everything around you feels hopeless. Hi guys, this is Linda from Brain Education TV. If this is your first time, welcome! Consider subscribing by clicking the subscribe button down below, like this video, and make sure to click the bell for new notifications of each episode. Today, I want to talk about finding hope. These days, there are so many things happening around us that make us lose hope. When you turn on the news, there's only news of deaths, violence, riots, protests, anger, sadness. And when our brains are exposed to this kind of information around the clock, the whole day, just negativity, 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 it's very easy for anybody to fall into a state of feeling hopeless. I think some people have a negative connotation about hope because hope seems like something that's not sure. Hope seems like something that's uncertain in the future. So why would I even want to feel hope when it's not certain and I don't know about the future? So yes, some people might feel that way about hope, but there are also others where hope can be a very powerful motivator, a powerful driving emotion and a driving force of energy that helps them go through pain in their life, go through suffering, break through their barriers. Hope is that raw power that lets us do that. Because without hope, why do we even try? Why do we even care? Why do we even live? If we didn't have hope for getting that promotion, why would you work harder? If we didn't have hope for finding that perfect spouse, why would we try to court people that we're interested in? If we didn't have hope to live a comfortable, wonderful life, why do we work so hard in life? We do all these things because we have hope. Students study hard because they have hope of getting into a good university, because they have hope that getting into a good university will give them a good job, and because they have hope that getting a good job will give them a comfortable life. So all of these things that we seek in life, the founding layer, the founding motivator, is actually hope. Hope makes life fun to live. Without hope, life is very meek and dull. Are you someone who waits for something outside of you to come to make you hopeful? Or are you someone who creates hope on his or her own despite what's happening around you? Most of us wait for something to happen to us for us to feel the emotion of hope. But only someone who has truly mastered their brain can feel hope even though everything in your life says to be hopeless. And to restore hope in your brain, to restore hope in your life so that you feel this passion and willpower and love for life again, focus on what you can control. What do I mean by that? In every situation, there are two sides. One side are things that I cannot control, like people's reactions, people's emotions, people's thoughts, people's behaviors. These are things that are beyond my control. But on the flip side of the same situation, there's always a side of it that I can control. For example, my actions, how I react, my thoughts, my behaviors. These are things that are totally in your control. When our brains focus only on trying to fix the element and we try to control the things that are beyond our control and we fail at doing it, you find no hope. In that state, we always feel like a victim. We always feel like we're losing. We always feel like we're getting the short end of the stick. And that is how people get stuck in hopelessness. But looking on the other side, yes, there are things that I cannot control. I must first accept that. Now look at that same situation with the lens of, but what can I control from this situation? When you've identified that, focusing your mind on that will help you realize that you have mastership of the situation. And now you don't feel like you're the loser, you feel like a winner because you're in control. So if you have a relationship, a job, a situation, a experience, a memory, an event, something that has made you lose hope, check your mind first. Am I focusing on trying to change the things that are beyond my control? Or is my mind really focused on the things that I can control? You'll see that when you lose hope in a situation, it's because you are trying to change the things that you cannot control. So shift your energy, shift your thoughts, shift your words, shift your behaviors to focus on the aspects of that situation, of that relationship, of that job, of that environment that is in your control. If you have a situation that you feel stumped on and you can't find any way that something in this situation can be in your control, let me know in the comments below. I'd love to help out. Or try implementing this idea in a problem that you face right now and see how your mind changes, and let me know that in the comments below too. I'd love to hear about them. So if you are someone who is desperately looking to find some hope in this chaotic, crazy time of ours right now, then please try to find what you can control and let go of things that you cannot control. Thanks so much, everyone, for tuning in. I love you all. Stay healthy, stay safe, take care of each other. See you in another video. Bye.